Hi everyone, my name is David Sobral. You might remember me from Physics 101, Functions and Differentiation. I'm a reader in astrophysics and I will be your lecturer for PHYS 263 Astronomy. In 263, you're going to get quite a broad overview of astronomy and astrophysics. For many of you, this will be your first module in astrophysics, while for others, this may be your only chance to actually learn about our amazing universe beyond our own planet. Astrophysics is absolutely amazing because it allows you to implement and apply all the physics that we learn here on Earth, and even to discover a lot of things that if we were just playing in our labs or doing theory, actually, in a basement or in a closed office, we would not realize it exists. Things like dark matter, dark energy, or almost everything else that we cannot find here on Earth, such as incredibly high temperatures or incredibly low temperatures. Now, even though astronomy could be portrayed as just pretty much taking pretty pictures, 263 astronomy is definitely not like that. And the first part of the module is actually all about making sure that you have the foundations to understand, apply physics to astronomy to really make it astrophysics. Some of the concepts that you're probably going to recap or revise have to do with black bodies, with spectra of hydrogen and helium when they get ionized. We're going to see how we can predict spectra and how we can use spectra to infer physics, such as temperature and metallicity, the amount of metals or heavy elements in stars, clouds, or galaxies. And once we have the tools, we'll start by looking at stars, how we can classify them, their diversity, and most strikingly, how from very limited observations, we can learn so much about them. We will then move into extrasolar planets, how we can discover them, what we've learned about them, our own solar system, including the Sun, before moving on to larger scales, including our own galaxy, how we discovered that our galaxy was not the only one in the universe, and then moving to, obviously, one of the best topics ever, which is extragalactic astrophysics, where we're going to start at the Big Bang and then try to follow the history of the universe as the first stars formed, the first galaxies formed, and how essentially they evolved to become galaxies like our own, and also focusing not just on the answers and the things that we know, but especially on the unknowns. The very final part of PHYS 263 is also dedicated to both the known unknowns and the unknown unknowns. Spectacular things like dark matter and dark energy, how we came about realizing that they exist and they matter so much, and also the efforts of trying to unveil their nature. This year it is very, very likely that there will be no face-to-face time apart from perhaps tutorials, and therefore I have recorded a series of videos to guide you through most of the important concepts. Sometimes I will literally appear in space around a star and to show you artistic impressions of extrasolar planets, galaxies, or even the large-scale structure of the universe. In many other cases, I'll try to use the whiteboard to do any derivations or show steps. And on top of that, I will try to use some more artistic ways of showing you the concepts. One important thing to point out is that you do have access to last year's lectures and to all the lecture slides. They are really comprehensive and they also have derivations step by step. But this year I've also written an astronomy and astrophysics book for you to use that will guide you through the lecture contents, the lecture material, and that hopefully will make the learning experience even better. All the videos that I record will be based and will follow the structure of the lecture notes or the book that I wrote for you. And I would suggest that you have those side by side as you watch some of these videos. You take notes and then you use the live discussion sessions to ask anything that is not clear and also to add to it. In case you do have any questions, I would always encourage you to use Teams or drop me an email and I'll try to reply as soon as possible. So I hope you're excited to start Astronomy 263 and start exploring our amazing universe with the physics tools you already got and the ones we're going to cover at the beginning of PHYS263. And even if astrophysics is really not your thing, I hope you can really appreciate how much we've already discovered about the universe, how crucial old physics is to understand phenomena beyond our planet Earth, and also to inspire you to perhaps try to unveil the nature of dark matter, dark energy, or any of the other many, many unsolved questions. So I'll see you soon for the first live session. Bye, everyone.
Liftoff of mission 41B, the first flight of the orbiter Discovery, and the shuttle has cleared the tower.
Welcome home, Columbia. Beautiful, beautiful.
You want us to take it up the hangar, Joe?
We're going to dust it off first.
3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0,
storm.